Welcome to this short energy and water reporting video for buildings by the City of Toronto.
Step 2. Getting started with Energy Star Portfolio Manager. This video will demonstrate how to set up your account and collect your building information. If you don't already have a Portfolio Manager account, your first step is to create one. Follow the link in the description below this video to go to the Portfolio Manager login screen. Once there, click the Create a New Account button. Enter your account information into the form. You will also be asked to identify your primary business type. You will be asked if you want your account name to be searchable by other Portfolio Manager users. If you intend to share your information with other people or companies, for example, engineers or architects associated with your properties, select Yes. Otherwise, select No. You can change this choice later if needed. When you have filled in all the account information, check the I'm not a robot box and click on the Create My Account button. A green bar will appear at the top of the screen, advising you to check your email for further instructions. In the email you receive from Portfolio Manager, click on the link to confirm your account. You must do this within 24 hours, or you will have to create a new account. The link will take you back to the Energy Star Portfolio Manager login page. Log in to confirm your account. You will receive a second confirmation email with a record of your username. Keep your username and password in a safe place for future reference. The first time you log into Portfolio Manager, you will be taken to your account's My Portfolio screen. You can return to this homepage easily by clicking on the Portfolio Manager logo at the top left of the screen. The first action you're going to want to take is to add properties to your account. But before you start creating building profiles in your Portfolio Manager account, we encourage you to use a Portfolio Manager Data Collection Worksheet to collect and record your building data. This will help you organize the information so that you can easily add it to your building profile. You'll find a link to Portfolio Manager's Data Requirements page in the description below. This page will tell you what data you need to enter into Portfolio Manager to benchmark your property. On the Portfolio Manager's Data Requirements page, select your country, Canada, then select your property type. Click the Lookup Required Data button. A list of the data required for your building type will be displayed. Some data collected is common for all building types, for example, property name and property address. Other data, in the Additional Data Collected section, is specific for the building type you have selected. To download the list of inputs required for your property, click on the Create PDF or Create Word button. You can use this downloaded worksheet as a reference when you are collecting the data you need to create your building profile. In support of the Ministry of Energy's EWRB program, some utilities offer online EWRB data request forms that you can use to request whole property monthly usage data from your utility. This is what Toronto Hydro's data request page looks like. You will need to fill out the PDF request form and email it to the Toronto Hydro email address provided. A link to Toronto Hydro's data request page is provided in the description below this video. Use the service address when requesting electricity data from Toronto Hydro. Toronto Hydro requires the service address registered for the property. This may be different from the Canada Post mailing address. Even if the property only has one building, the building address can be on one street, and the service address can be around the corner. You can request your natural gas consumption data using Enbridge Gas's online data request form. You can find a link to the Enbridge data request form in the description below this video. Enbridge will email you an Excel file containing your property's gas consumption data. You can use the City of Toronto's online self-help portal to download your building's water data. A link to Toronto Water's online self-help portal is included in the description below this video. To access your water data, click the My Water Toronto button. Then, enter the required information and click Submit. Tip: if your postal code is rejected, leave the postal code field blank. On the My Water Toronto application page, select Monthly as the interval type. Scroll back up to the top of the page and use the Select Year field to select the year of data you want to view. To download your water consumption data for the year you selected, click on the green Excel icon in the top right corner of the monthly water use data table. The data will download as a CSV file, which you can open in Excel and save as an Excel document. Here are some additional tips for requesting data from utilities. Request utility data early. Reach out early to obtain whole building data for your property from utility companies. Utilities require time to process data requests, up to 4 weeks, so be sure to submit your data request as soon as possible. Request whole property data. When you are requesting data from your utility, keep in mind that you need whole property data. In some cases, a utility meter may be shared between two properties, and usage must be prorated based on your cost-sharing agreement. Include the correct utility account holder information when requesting data from utilities. Utility accounts belong to legal entities. When contacting utilities, provide the correct account holder information to avoid delays getting access to your data. Keep your monthly utility bills. Make sure to keep your monthly utility bills as backup documents for annual EWRB reporting. Estimates for meters can sometimes be inaccurate. Your monthly bills can help you reconcile aggregated consumption data when needed.
Thank you for watching the City of Toronto video on energy and water reporting for buildings.